For example, if we see that somebody make a sin, and in heart we will know that this person make a sin, but because we please the people and we say amen, yeah, Father, Father, and all the people will answer amen. When we say the amen, it means that we are agree with the curse of disobedience. So these curses how comes in our life when we will disobedience of the word of God. And the 28th chapter is full of blessing, the blessings of obedience. If we will read from the chapter 28, same Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 16 to 19. Yes, from verse 16 to 19.
Curse shall not be in the city, and curse shall not be in the country. Curse shall not be basket and your kneeling bar. Curse shall be the fruit of your body, and the product of your land, and the increase of your cattle, and the offspring of your blood. Curse shall you be when you come in, and curse shall you be when you go out.
Now verse 30.
Verse 30.
Yes, 30. 30 to 32.
You shall betroth a wife, but another man shall lie with her. You shall build a house, but you shall not dwell in it. You shall plant a vineyard, but you shall not gather its crops. 31. Your house shall be cypress before your eyes, but you shall not eat of it. Your donkey shall be violently taken away from before you, and shall not be restored to you. Your sheep shall be given to your enemies, and you shall have no one to rescue them.
32.
32. Your sons and your daughters shall be given to another people, and your eyes shall look and pray with longing for them all day long. And there shall be no strength in you.
Amen. Hallelujah. So here, my brothers and sisters, these all scriptures are telling us that how we come under the curse. Because when we are not obeying the word of God, how the curses come in our life. When we will come inside, the curse is upon us. When we go outside, the curse is upon us. Whatever we do, where we put our hands, we do go to job, we are under curse. So these scriptures say that even after we say that this is a generation curse. So verse 32, I will repeat here, but we will say last Sunday, the seed of curse. Your sons and daughters will be given as slaves to foreigners. While you look on, every day you will strain your eyes looking in vain for your children to return. Amen. So here Bible is very clear that when we are not obeying the word of God, so our children of children and our generation of generation come under the curse. And we must obey the word of God. And you know, in there, in the Bible, there are many, many scriptures. So just note down the scriptures when you have a time, you can read it, that how our children come under the curse. Exodus chapter 20. Verse 5, Exodus chapter 22, verse 24, Deuteronomy chapter 5 to 9. And somebody will read Exodus chapter 34, verse 6 to 7. These all scriptures tell us the children when they come under the curse, the generation curse. Exodus 34, verse 6 to 7. 34, verse 6 to 7.
And the Lord passed before him and proclaimed, the Lord, God, merciful and gracious, long-suffering, and abounding in goodness and truth. 7. Keeping mercy for the sin, forgiving iniquity and transgression, and sin by by no means cleaning the youth, visiting the iniquity of the father upon the children, and the children's to the tenth and the fourth generation.
Amen.